is good. Back, back, forward. Is this good? All right. Hello. I am prisoner 442. I just state my name. Okay. My name is Ridley. Ridley the Riddler. Don't shake your hand. Got it. I'm sorry. I will keep my hands to myself. My name is Ridley the Riddler. State why I'm here. Well, I tried to rob a car, and then the cops chased me, into a zoo where I promptly crashed, and then I ran away from the cops and I hopped on Rhino in captivity and I tried to run away on Rhino, which did not go over too well. Rhino ran, but he could not outrun a car, which is good to know for next time. ain't gonna be no next time, but don't get on the Rhino. Next time, try the elephant. hands up. I don't have anything on me. I mean, you already put me in the suit. I'm pretty sure you know there's nothing on me. Come on now. Alright, no. But yeah, I am Ridley. And I did drive a car into the zoo where I promptly rode a rhino. And that's not funny. That is not okay. And I am aware that you should not steal a car or drive said car into a zoo or ride a rhino, and I repent and I am ready for bail. I guess that's not all I did. You want to know everything I'm being charged for? Well, that's all I'm really guilty of. Everything else is kind of water under the cloud, if you know what I'm saying. I'm sorry, I will not joke no more. I took some bread from a baby, but if I'm being perfectly honest, that baby is too young. It should have still been breastfeeding. If anything, I saved it. And I was hungry and I wanted some bread. What? Did I have money? Yeah, I had money for bread, but the baby had bread right there. And quite frankly, I wanted that bread. And a baby looks you in the eye and he says, "This is my bread, this is what I'm taking." You can't help but look at that little guy and go, "Look at your arms, little guy. I mean, you ain't got no muscle. Look at my arms." And then you just take that bread from that baby. And then as he cries, sweet tears of sugar, as you taste that thing going down. So anyway, yeah, I took bread from a baby. That's not really a crime. Y'all are just nitpicking. Y'all gotta stop nitpicking. Alright. Stole the car, crashed it to the zoo, rode the rhino, stole bread from a baby. That ain't that bad. A good person could do that. I'm a good person. Look into my eyes. I illegally took a hypnotist class to try and sleep with women. Well, women wouldn't sleep with me, so I took the hypnotist class. You know, I read once that, like, with a hypnotist class, you couldn't make anything do what they didn't want to do. And, so, I figure that's okay. But no, in the eyes of the law, I guess that's not okay. But that's not really a crime. That's just a side hobby. I also started a car washing business, but I didn't really wash cars. I stood in a bikini in front of a car wash, and when anyone would come up to me and give me the money, I'd run away. And they should just know better. See a man in a bikini, they should just know that it ain't gonna be right, you know. Just like the baby should see me coming, he shouldn't be so cocky. And you know, they really shouldn't let me into hypnotist school. I had no business there, and they should have seen it coming. That was their fault. Keep my hands down. All right, I'll keep my hands down. So I drew a knife on a chef. It was a butter knife, though. So, I mean, take that as you will. Like, what's a butter knife gonna do? I mean, come on. That's a hollow threat. He don't have to worry about that. I don't know why he called the cops on me. That's just ridiculous. Butter knife's all around. I was literally buttering a biscuit, and he's at fault. I should be getting him in trouble. You know what that man says to me? He says, you have enough butter. Like, he knows what my business is. He don't know about my business. You know, that's right. I could have hit him in the eye. I suppose that's right. I repent, and I deserve to be forgiven for that. Also, I put laundry detergent in every fountain in the tri-state area. But to be fair, that was just, I was just being an activist for the environment, because everybody knows laundry detergent makes a big old mess. And I proved that by putting it in the fountains. It made a big old mess, and then they had to clean it up, and I think they know better now. And I think people are using less laundry detergent. Yeah, really, I'm a hero. I don't deserve to be hearing this. Yes, I'll keep my hands down. I'm sorry. Can't itch now. This is America. I can itch. I tell you. Yeah, I keep going. I know what I did. I know what I did. I farted at a funeral. Okay. I mean, I know that doesn't sound like a crime, but I needed to clear the room, so I purposely ate some things that makes your fart sound and smell nasty, and so I just let her rip in the middle of a funeral, and I just scattered the whole place. And then I was free to take the gold necklace off the old corpse there. Yeah, that was a pretty good gig. I made some good money, but no, I repent. I repent. That was not okay. I wouldn't do that again. That's nice. That's nice. Yeah, I will not be farting at a funeral again to clear out the room. That's for sure. So if y'all could let me go now, I really didn't do that much. I mean, since when's farting a crime? Taking the gold chain off the corpse is a crime, not the fart. Are you sure? Because I feel like the fart harmed more people. The corpse is already dead. I don't think he needed that. Okay, well, I suppose that's that. All right, well, I just stepped down over here. You ain't gonna hose me down again. I can't be doing that. All right, I'm gonna go over here now. Okay, thank you. I hope to make parole, and that's a really pretty outfit you got on there, and okay.